is the urban debate on Magicbricks Now. I'm Faye D'Souza. Let's take a look at the headlines today. Karnataka will in fact release water for irrigation in the Kaveri Basin. That is the latest in the Kaveri dispute. The government resolution comes ahead of the Supreme Court hearing when the Karnataka government is expected to file a petition on the 4th of October. And citizens of Bangalore will be allowed to decide how their civic body will utilize their money. The Bangalore civic body, the BBMP, partners with NGO Janagraha to gather budget requests and suggestions from citizens. And shocking news for citizens of Mumbai. Contaminated water leaves 60 families in the heart of Mumbai fighting for life. The Mumbai civic body BMC is blamed for ignoring warnings for the last 4 months. As now green and brown contaminated water makes citizens sick. Well, our focus tonight is the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. In a country where nearly half of the population still doesn't have toilets, the Prime Minister Modi's ambitious Swachh Bharat Abhiyan completes its second anniversary. But it's a long, long way off from its goals. The Swachh Bharat cess has already collected over 4,000 crore rupees, and the World Bank has provided the project with an additional funding of 9,000 crore rupees. We still, though, need 88 million toilets to be built in the next 3 years to meet the government's targets. Tonight, we ask if the Swachh Bharat campaign is a mere photo op, or is it a campaign that's sweeping to success? We went around and we talked to citizens across the country about the mission. Listen in.
If you see people in train, they're eating oranges and just they're throwing garbage in train itself. So I think education to all those kind of people is a must. Then secondly, there should be garbage collectors or bins at the railway station especially, because you can't find dustbin anywhere.
Nothing is swatch still now. Everything is so dirty around. We walk all the way home. It's bad. It's just we're paying, but I don't know for what we're paying.
Seen people, my friends, you know, who used to litter on the roads and otherwise, they are now keeping all the garbages or, you know, wrappers of trophies in their pockets and throwing when they see a dustbin.
Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is a nice initiative taken by Modi ji, and I feel people are getting educated. People, I have seen the improvement. There is a lot of improvement seen in 6 months. I'm seeing this thing in my station, at my home, very near to everyone is speaking. Even the, I am very happy that the children are getting very appreciating this thing.
Government has launched many schemes. These schemes are gaining momentum. They have been marketed well, so people know them. But results, I'm really not sure how they are reflective, because I don't see day-to-day my life Swachh Bharat, Swachhata has really improved.
It's been a very good start, actually, frankly speaking. At least there is an initiative to clean up the, like this way we walk around, you go on the street, if somebody puts, throws a trash around there or here, if until it puts into this some basket there, that seems good. It looks very clean and tidy.
I don't think so that the government can help in any way for doing a Swachh Bharat. It's up to the people who will be helping to do that.
Bathroom should be cleaned properly, which are not yet up to date. And as far as consideration station, it is better from last 6 months or so.
Jitna main ghuma utna saaf nazar aaya. Dustbin ho jaye to aur acha hai. Saaf sutra karna aur bahiya baat hai.
This railway station is very clear, but aur thoda clear ho to bahut acha hota tha. Thoda aur dustbin hota to.
Ab penalty ke dar se bhi logon ne bahut sudhar kara hai apne andar. Koi bhi ab thukta dustbin mein thukta hai, khata hai, kuda to dustbin dalta hai, railway track pe koi nahi dalta. To thodi si safai to hai pehle se.
Clear hai, acha hai, pehle se kafi zyada safai hai. लोगों की वजह से भी है क्योंकि अब वो गंदगी कम फैला रहे हैं.
This place is like most of the times you find the crowd here, so definitely it looks clean. But if you go to some other parts of the city, it needs to be cleaner as well.
Few places are actually, you know, turned out to be really clean and all, but there are more places to look after.
I think it depends on the citizens. First of all, they have to like stop littering everywhere, and the dustbin should be like kept in every 100 meters so that they don't litter everywhere.
I think Aarti Nagar needs attention in Bangalore. I think that has got a lot of areas which is not clean, and not the litter is like everywhere.
Like everywhere there's a lot of dust and pollution. No? It's not the guys who are doing the cleaning, the BBMP, they're not cleaning properly.
Well, the question we are asking this evening is the Swachh Bharat campaign on track? Is it actually achieving anything, or is it just a photo op? Joining me on the show this evening, Ashish Dua, National Spokesperson of the Congress, Ashish Sood, State General Secretary of the BJP in Delhi, Rishi Agarwal, Environmentalist, Ronak Sutaria is the Chief Technologist at IndiaSpend. That company does a lot of work in tracking the spends of the government. Subbaiah TS, the founder of Citizens for Sustainability, will join us through the course of this conversation. And Dr. Suman Chahar is the Senior Vice President at Sulabh International. I want to thank all of you for joining us on the show. Ronak, I'll start with you. The numbers, the numbers are something that the citizens are very interested in. 4,000 crore rupees collected under the Swachh Bharat cess already, plus an extra funding from the World Bank. How is the money being utilized according to your research?
No, I mean, actually, we've been asking the BMC to release this proactively since a long time. And in fact, we've been, there's this whole social audit team that has been set up.
Right.
But we've been stonewalled repeatedly for the access to proactive data from the BMC. And in fact, we've been sitting in meetings with them spread over a year and a half. And we've not actually made any headway. I mean, I've spoken about this earlier also. But the willingness has been shown by the BMC, but unfortunately, the intermediate agencies have actually really not enabled any kind of access to periodic data.
So Ronak, tell me something. We know that the Swachh Bharat cess, which is levied by the central government, goes into a consolidated fund. Mm-hmm. The central government then may decide what to do with that money, and we could allot it to various cities or various states to be used. Now, there's some data that says that these many toilets have been built, which the government is telling us. Is there any way to verify that data right now?
No, honestly, I mean, that is not being released either by the central government or the agencies which are receiving those funds.
Hmm.
Not sufficient information has been shared. Because where that's, I mean, we all see it as a line item in our bills.
Yes.
That there is a Swachh Bharat cess going. But unfortunately, there is no real clarity on where can people get information on who is getting those funds and what is the, how is it trickling down. So we've not received any information so far in our interactions with the local governments.
All right, so there's no information about where the money is going. Rishi Agarwal, I know that this is an area that you have been working in personally for a very long time. I just want to understand a very simple thing from you. While you were working at, you know, with cleanliness, with open defecation, with problems that it causes on health, post the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, have things changed, or is it just as difficult to get the government to act on these things?
Well, see, I would say that there is no marked difference in the way of the working of the government. I can, of course, count on
Tell me what projects you're working on, which ones you're referring to exactly.
See, I think we've discussed Devna dumping ground. I think that remains my pet project, that how can we reduce the amount of garbage going to our dumping grounds. We've had a great monsoon, there is no fire, but come Jan, Feb, again, because it will become dry. So we're not seeing segregation at source happening still. We're not seeing implementation of, say, plastic bags, I mean, below 50 microns, etc., happening. I can still show you vegetable wounders, which are completely blatantly violating the law. And I can show you municipal premises, which themselves are so dirty.
Mm.
I can show you the municipal toilets, which are stinking. I mean, when you go to meet the assistant commissioner, etc., all that you get is a smell of sanitation, etc. So I think within the government buildings itself, I can show you pictures of RTO, Andheri, Wadala. Horrible pictures. I mean, the toilets are dysfunctional, spitting everywhere. So I think the least that could have been done was to establish certain islands of excellence. And we are still not seeing those kind of things. I mean, if you want to see an island of excellence, you have to necessarily go to the international airport, which not all of us, I think, can do. I mean, those kind of standards of cleanliness in our railway stations, for example, are missing, in our public buildings are missing. So I don't think there is a appreciable difference made since the 2 years of this campaign.
Right, Ashish Dua, I bring you in here. What is your response right now to what you're hearing about the Swachh Bharat campaign?
See, the figures and the facts that have been laid on the table by the experts, those two experts who just spoke before me, have exposed the scheme in itself. On top of that, the fanfare with which the flagship scheme of the government was launched 2 years ago has belied its own disproportionate publicity by the results on the ground. You see Delhi, and they've already said that 4,000 crores of cess has been collected. Delhi has gone from bad to worse. Similar way would be for Mumbai. The municipalities are not being given money. The employees are not able to get money, the salaries. And then on top of that, this initiative of money collection, which has been only spent in events, photo ops, ads, publicity, and paying to the brand ambassadors, I think that has exposed the scheme in itself. Once you see that, spread of chikungunya, spread of dengue in such a vast proportion in Delhi, that is because of the strewn garbage all over. I mean, right. your screen shows the garbage, amount of garbage, amount of stink that you go through once you travel through Delhi, once you drive through Delhi. That speaks volumes about the Swachh Bharat. Symbolism, like in other flagship schemes, has not worked in this case too. And the fact, the government has laid out disproportionate figures has been claimed by the CAG reports. The CAG reports quickly, if I would give you for one state, for Jharkhand, they say that the toilets that were there for they were not there for 92% rural households in year 2011, but surprisingly by 2015 the toilets were the figure was 66%, which belies for itself. The CAG report says that Union Government of India has inflated figures in Jharkhand by 327%, in Madhya Pradesh by 277%, Odisha right. It is 199%. If you're just giving for the sake of numbers, if you're just spreading these lies for the sake of numbers,
so you're saying you don't believe any of the numbers coming out of the central government
the garbage
right now.
Would show you all.
You don't believe any of the numbers coming out of the central government right now, Ashish Sood. You've heard the panel.
Inflated numbers.
Right. You've heard the panel on the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan or the Swachh Bharat scheme. Tell us where the government stands right now on what work is being done.
First of all, I am surprised to listen to what Mr. Dua was saying, the Congress representative on the show was saying. As if all these 68 years before 2014, Sri Modi took over as the Prime Minister,
you can
as
check
if
them.
All the
if you don't believe me, please,
things
please
regarding
them.
Yes. You should be ashamed for last 68 years. In 2014 there was only 697 villages defecation free, open defecation free. Is this not the result of 68 years of misrule? You people were not able to educate. You people were not able to think about the things.
I have the figures. Mr. Ashish, the question that I'm asking you this evening.
68 years after independence, you were ruling the state. Yes.
Mr. Ashish, so the question I'm asking you right now, Ronak just told us...
You were ruling this country.
Ronak just told us that we are unable to, from outside the government, track the money, track the spends of the Swachh Bharat cess that every citizen is paying on every service that they use. So along with service tax, we pay a Swachh Bharat cess. 4,000 crore rupees have been collected. We are unable to track the spending of that 4,000 crore rupees. Please tell us where the money is going and how it's being used right now.
Yes, people who have never travelled in the train for last 10 years commenting upon the trains are not good will give you these kind of figures only.
My question is very simple. Please tell us where the money is being spent. Please tell us where the money is being spent.
You can't criticize at all.
Please tell us how the money is being spent.
It will very soon come on. You don't expect me to carry where the money is going. Do you expect to carry the whole amount of money, at least in Delhi, as the state general secretary of the BJP in Delhi?
Do you know where the money is being spent in Delhi?
Don't you know? Just listen to me. Let me complete first.
Okay.
This is no way to. Just let me complete first.
Okay.
Don't you know? In 2014, there were only 697 villages
which were defecation free, which has been rose to more than 2000 in year 2016. How many districts were defecation free in 2014? With the people who are wanting to track the money, are they unaware about these figures?
All right, so you know, Ronak, only, these are the numbers that have come out from the government as of September 28th.
There were only 7 districts in
2014. 1,536 villages have been declared open defecation free. Mm-hmm. 23 districts are open defecation free. These are numbers that the government has released. Respond to that.
No, I think, see, I mean, Mr. Sood, to respond to his earlier point that...
1.5 years, what were they? What were they questioning the previous governments in 68 years?
Go on, Ronak.
No, fair enough. Mr. Sood, the last 68 years, we didn't have the kind of information and technology that is available since the past 5 years. So my whole contention here is that, you know, you are saying you don't need to move around.
No,
just a minute, Mr. Sood. You made several claims, including the fact that we've not traveled by train. So I'll be very happy to provide a receipt of my train travel from Varanasi to Kanpur just 3 days ago. So to put you at rest, I'll be most happy to email you that we do travel very frequently by train. And I have a train receipt in my name from a train ride from Varanasi to Kanpur, which I'll be happy to send to you. But coming back to the point. Just a minute, Mr. Sood.
Same as you were traveling in 2011?
Anyway, I'm going to address the point.
Same as you were traveling in 2011?
I don't understand your question, but I'll refer to the core issues that you have raised, is that you don't need to move around with a sheet of paper.
So are the trains similar as the trains you were traveling in 2011?
The conditions near the trains is identical to what we've been seeing for the past 5 years, because I have been moving in the trains. The trains may have been better, but the streets around the trains, there has been no difference. And in fact, there is a significant... I was honestly in Varanasi there for a week, the past week, and it was a really sad sight to see the condition of the city there, being the constituency of the PM. But coming back to the core issue at hand, I mean, nobody's asking for sheets of paper to be shown. What we are all saying is, please provide us with a single line of information on where can a common citizen go and see on where is those funds coming in on a daily basis.
There should be Suomoto disclosure. Why should a citizen
just,
have
to ask? Single
just put it up on your Swachh Bharat website.
You are there in New Delhi.
I mean, the Modi campaign used technology enormously for PR, for election propaganda purposes.
This is true, that the job of cleaning any city, whether that is Delhi, Bangalore, Pune, Mumbai, belongs to the local municipality.
Absolutely.
Of the local municipality gets money with funding from taxes that they charge and collect, property tax, parking, anything else that they charge and collect. So this money of Swachh Bharat cess is going to the central government. How is it finding its way back to each city? How is the central government deciding how much of an allocation will each city receive? And who's tracking the spending? So let's assume the BMC, which is already over flushed with cash, receives more cash. Who's tracking that spend, Ron?
No, I mean, the BMC, puts out certain spending information in terms of POs that they release, the purchase orders. But that also is provided in such a convoluted manner that if anybody really wants to do any analysis or does want to do any social audits, it makes it very, very difficult. You know, I think they make it as difficult as possible. And, you know, and honestly, I mean, we want to share, because there's somebody from the BJP and Congress. You know, I mean, activist or no activist, a common citizen is indeed wanting to help. You know, nobody is trying to put fingers or blame anybody here.
Absolutely.
I mean, the whole tragedy of the situation is that people are dying to help, and there is no willingness to receive that help. In fact, there is. You know, you start questioning me whether if I've traveled by train, or you start questioning the organization where I work. We've been questioned about our funding in the past. And what is a pity here is that, you know, instead of just discussing the facts on hand, people want to just constantly...
I mean, it's shooting the messenger kind of a thing. You just don't want to hear any kind of a bad news at all.
I also want to bring in Dr. Suman Chahar.
The other representatives have also the equal right to question you.
No, that's fair enough.
You're absolutely on point, Ashish. We welcome your questions. Dr. Suman Chahar, we know that the Swachh Bharat campaign has the funding gets split into two. There's rural and there's an urban spend. And this is something that I believe every urban Indian should be interested in, because there's still open defecation in each of our cities. And that makes your children sick. There's garbage that's still rotting at the end of our streets, and it makes our families sick. We have jaundice, we have dengue, we have other diseases which should have, in a country like India, been completely eradicated by now. Dr. Suman Chahar, tell me, from the point of view of our urban centres, how much have things changed in the last 2 years in terms of creating public toilets and stopping open defecation?
From last 2 years, we have observed that people are taking interest in the Swachh Bharat mission. Mm-hmm. And from many last governments, we have seen every government has took interest, and they have their governments has done a lot. But our current Prime Minister, when he spoke from Red Fort for Swachh Bharat mission, then everybody sensitizes. Earlier, I am from the organization. Since more than 46 years, Sulabh is working in this sector. And earlier, we used to sensitize people. We used to convey people that this locality requires community toilet complex, this locality requires public toilets. But definitely, response was there.
Dr. Chahar, the point that you're making is that more people are sensitive, more people are willing to help, more people want the good work to be done.
Yes, yes.
Okay. But in terms of the actual work being done on the ground, the toilets being built, has that become easier for your organization?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Now people are taking interest, government officers, corporates, all are coming forward to come forward for urban sanitation, rural sanitation. And we are working with the local bodies, state government, central government, and corporates.
How many toilets have been built in the cities of Mumbai and Delhi in the last 2 years?
Like public toilets?
Yes.
Yes. Organization has done that. I'll get back to you because our team are working in Maharashtra, branches working very hard.
All right, so we still don't have the numbers. We're still having trouble tracking
the
progress on this project.
The big point which I've been making in the past 2 years also is that this whole messaging of the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan has been all about citizens, and citizens have to do this and citizens have to do that. The attention
which is
completely
fair.
Let's take
the fact that it is people are more sensitive right now.
Yeah, but the point I'm making is that it is almost being used as a tool to deflect attention from the functioning of the government itself. Primarily, this is a governance issue. This is not as much an issue of funds or technology, both of which are abundant. Mm. It is an issue of how our municipal corporations, our councils, our zilla panchayats, everybody works. And there is not much of a difference in that at all. And that is what needs to be fixed up. And that is not getting fixed up. And that is what is the big change in government that we're looking at least in this arena.
Ronak?
Yeah, you know, Faye, I mean, the one other point I would like to mention, and, you know, we started tracking this whole plastic waste.
I would like to...
Yes, I'll come to you. As soon as Ronak finishes making his point, I'll come to you, Mr.
And, you know, I would also like to mention that this is not just, I mean, yes, the responsibility of the governments and the citizens is there. You know, globally, there is a lot of responsibility being put on the corporates also who generate a lot of the waste which ultimately comes to our landfill. And there is a very interesting project which we are kind of just starting to work with called the Plastic Disclosure Project, where large corporates, you know, FMCG kind of companies who are utilizing the plastic are proactively disclosing the amount of plastic that goes into various products of theirs. And I think it actually is a cumulative effect that, you know, we are seeing the garbage which is showing up on our streets. Yes, clearing the garbage is one part of the story, but I think we also need to hold some people accountable who are, you know, generating it. You know, consumers are one end of it, but producers also need to be made aware that they are, you know, adding to this whole issue.
Right.
And by very...
But if we were to go straight to the government at this point with the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, do we want more information here? Do we want clearer instructions? Is the method in which the money is being used, does that need to change? What needs to change?
I mean, definitely. I think on the cleanliness side and on the execution side, I think there is not much of transparency or clarity on how exactly are they executing it. And the end result, of course, is all for all to see. So in terms of the day-to-day execution, yes, I mean, we would be most happy if they would share with us how exactly are they rolling things out. Mm. And definitely if they were willing to partner with people on the ground, then more people would join in. But right now they have not shown any avenues where people can pitch in.
All right. Ashish Sood, you wanted to respond to that. Go ahead.
I wanted to share information with you people.
Yes.
That there, as per a recent data released by the Ministry of Sanitation and Water, as many as 23 million toilets have been built across the country, which means 55% of the Indian households had toilets till September 28, 2016. And to your surprise, to Mr. Dua's surprise, which is up by 42% in 2014. So this was the state of affairs of the state of toilet and the sanitation in the country when this present government took over. And from where, if we are trying to take it to a step forward, no government can deliver without the people's participation. So criticizing the government that it is just talking about only people, 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 no government, no elected individual, I can bet upon it, can deliver without the people's participation in it. The sanitation conditions in any city, any country will not change if the people don't participate into it actively. And this Swachh Bharat Abhiyan has sanitized the people, sensationalized the people about the need. Now, before people traveling in the car used to open their windshields and throw the things outside. Now the children sitting by their side are stopping them. This is the change we have been able to bring within 2 years. And the numbers I have quoted, just ask your panelist, Mr. Dua, who was talking up great about the Congress regime, to counter these numbers. And if they have left this kind of state of affairs to the country in 2014, they should be ashamed instead of criticizing the present government.
All right. Ashish Dua, respond to that, that there are numbers, according to Mr. Sood, there are numbers.
Unfortunately, you know, when Mr. Sood was, I think, not listening when I was, blasting his claims of overinflated claims of the government, I would repeat those figures now, since he's read those figures and he should be knowing those figures by now. And you know, the unfortunate part about this government is, except for once you question them on deliverables, they only talk of rhetoric, they only talk of tall claims, and the entire money that should have been spent on real issues has or on governance or on policy has gone only on events, event management, photo ops, and brand ambassadors.
And
that goes from one scheme to another. That is true from scheme to scheme.
2D, 3D and Jijaji are the real issues.
What you don't seem to realize is Delhi has gone from bad to worse. It has become a hell to live in with BJP's municipal corporations of Delhi.
Yes, Delhi has gone back to worse. They're just
stealing money of the public.
Into the government with them for 49 days.
Yeah, because municipal corporation
partners.
Municipal corporation is ruling Delhi.
You've
been in power in municipal corporation and sanitation and cleanliness is responsibility of this BJP municipal corporation.
Did your office of RG?
Are the toilets functional? Are the toilets clean? People can go into those toilets? You don't seem to realize. You are living in a false world. You're cheating the people of the country by spending money.
Yes, for 68
years. I'll give you another example of give it up that you did.
Yes, you were not able to construct toilets.
All right. Mr. Dua, Mr. Sood, we're running out of time on this discussion. I want to point out in any of our big cities right now, Delhi has a mosquito-borne disease epidemic. Because of the waterlogging, because of the mess, the High Court has pulled up both governments and the municipal corporation saying, why hasn't this been solved yet? Mumbai has a problem with jaundice, has a problem with dirty
only
water.
Only 25,000 rupees fine. I want to correct you.
No, I couldn't
only
share that simple example, which unfortunately,
state
between this
who was not
clanging
able to
match between
substantiate its claim by the evidences.
Okay, Rishi, go ahead.
No, I just wanted to share that example. 2 days back, I did the survey because in this slanging match, we missed out on that. Mumbai has 100-odd police stations. All the police stations are capturing, getting accident vehicles, stolen vehicles. These vehicles are just littered all around the police stations and they decay for tens of years. I mean, some vehicles might be for 10 more years. I shared some of the photographs as well. All of these vehicles become receptacles for water. They collect water. I've been speaking with police constables. They're saying, okay, in this police station, 7 people got dengue, in the other one, 10. Now, these are the simple systemic issues which really shouldn't take more than 2 months to resolve. We have 2 years, and of course, then every time you say that it's been 2 years, we have said that for 68 years, nothing was happening. But the kind of images you're seeing right now, the BMC should be, the municipal corporation should be providing a separate plot. These vehicles should be stored over there. Again, coming to another example.
And if they have not been claimed, they should just be moved out.
No, absolutely. I mean, again, another example, there are 5 different spots I can show around where we are sitting. And since I'm continuously on the streets, you will still find spots where garbage is accumulated. You will find cows eating those same garbage.
In all of our cities.
And all over, we are seeing that on the streets. Now, I don't need to get some big number crunching and some big analysis to say, okay, CAG said this and so many funds and so much cess funds. I mean, I don't get into this thing. I just rely on simple parameters for my analysis, which is just move around on the street and what is your feel of different areas. And the feel is that there really is no perceptible difference at all. And these things should not take, in my opinion, more than 6 months to resolve. So if the government has been already around for 2 years, I don't want to be every time I bring up that point, oh, then what were you doing for 68 years? No, I've been involved in doing activism for 20 odd years. I know for the fact what is the timeline for 20 years. And we are, I think, still stuck up in very juvenile discussions around cleanliness.
Ashish Dua, go ahead.
Delivered in 20 years.
Yeah. In fact, you know, I would give you just another figure for Gurgaon,
kind of
which is a millennium city.
The panelists
in a survey recently, in a recent survey that was conducted, 64% of the residents said there was no impact of the Swachh Bharat, while 12% said it has gone worse. So that makes it 76%. So rest of the once you see the voting pattern, 60% people voted for BJP. So out of that, you've lost almost 40% of your constituency straight away. That, you know, your own voters don't believe what you've done.
Who, Ashish Dua, who conducted this survey? Which agency conducted this survey?
Mr. Dua, I would like to respond to Mr. Dua.
I'll mail you that survey.
You are talking about a survey in Gurgaon, Mr. Dua.
We'll send you that survey across.
Mr. Dua, please listen to me for a second.
No, in fact, you know...
Very recently, you are talking about a recent survey.
2 years have got completed.
I want to remind you, when your president, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, went to Bangalore and asked the people, asked the youngsters whether something is being done about the Swachh Bharat or not, he was slapped with a very good reply. Please remember that. Rahul Gandhi, your president, went to Bangalore IIM and he was given a...
We're not making any progress here. Mr. Sood, Mr. Dua, we're not making any progress here. If we acknowledge on this panel that sensitizing the population, Mr. Sood, if we acknowledge on this panel, and I do want to acknowledge that people in India are far more sensitive about keeping their neighborhoods clean. Like Ronak rightfully pointed out, people, citizens want to help. We were running footage on our screen of citizens who spent the weekend in the name of Swachh Bharat, in the name of Gandhi Jayanti, cleaning up Varsova Beach. These are regular citizens, these are school children who went out and they spent the entire weekend cleaning up the beach, picking up garbage. Citizens want to help and they are far more sensitive about cleanliness post the Swachh Bharat campaign than before. But my question is, in actually cleaning up our cities, and a portion, nearly half of the Swachh Bharat campaign is dedicated towards urban cleanliness. How much of that is arriving at urban cleanliness and what are we doing? How are we going to use that money? What change can we expect to see in our cities, Mr. Sood?
Faye, if I may just quickly add these images which you're showing about Varsova Beach cleanup and some of my friends are leading it. I think any of these kind of images are a proof that the solid waste management system is completely broken down.
Is the question addressed to me?
Thousands and thousands of plastic bags filled with garbage are finding their way into the nalas of Mumbai, which then drain out into the bigger creeks, which drain out into the sea, and then the sea throws it back on the beach. So, I mean, citizens should not be doing what they're doing over here at all. There should be sophisticated machinery which should be employed to clean up the beaches in the first place. So much of garbage should not find its way into our nalas and creeks. Down solid waste management system, which in the past 2 years also has not been repaired at all.
Mr. Sood, my question to you again. How can we expect, what changes can we expect over the next few years in our urban centers, on the streets of Delhi and Bangalore and Mumbai and Pune? What sort of changes can we expect to see?
I tell you. Yes, I'll tell you. Look, earlier, all the cities were being kept and maintained by the municipal solid waste rules of 2005. Hmm. I agree, handling municipal solid waste in the various parts of city, various parts of the country is a big problem. Because in India, easier said than done, because to manage and segregate waste, because Indian culture and the Indian generation of waste is altogether different from the other countries. In the other countries, one day the biodegradable waste is taken, one day the e-waste and the glass is being taken. But in India, we have a different kind of a culture. Now, the municipal solid management rules of 2016 are in force. Just let me complete. I know you have a divergent view from me, but let me reply to the question which has been posed to me. Now the municipal solid management waste rules of 2016 have come up. As per that, all the municipalities will have to come out with the private concessioners and with the new technology to handle the waste. Things will improve with that. Many municipalities are having good amount of resources, others are not. So in the Swachh Bharat mission, the urban areas will be given fund from this collection of cess for the handling of municipal solid waste and the construction of community toilets, and the rural areas, the individual toilets will be the more focus, and the sensitivity, increasing of sensitivity among the rural people will be the focus. So these are the two ways the funds will be, are proposed to be spent in the rural and urban areas.
Funds will be allocated to municipal corporations who don't have the money right now. I'm still worried, Ronak, and I know you'll agree, I'm still worried about the utilization of that money. Like, for example, in Mumbai, Mumbai doesn't need any more money. We have plenty of money. We're just not using it. So on some level, the architects of the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan will also have to track the utilization of the money they're handing out, wouldn't they?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think without adequate, monitoring and auditing, it is a very one-sided effort, and it's a non-transparent effort. So, I mean, I think to make this a more equitable way of solving the problem, I think there is a need to bring wider, actors into the whole picture, because this problem affects all of us. You know, I mean, I have somebody in my office whose 3-year-old daughter is right now fighting chikungunya. I mean, it's a sorry state to see, you know, that somebody who's 3 years old is, battling these things. And I think, being more open and transparent really is the way forward. Because I think if they try to do a top-down approach, I don't think it is going to work for a city like Bombay or any of our metro cities. I mean, I think it'll have to be a lateral approach, and we don't see any elements of that happening.
And Mr. Sood, what we're watching on our screen right now, the Versova Beach cleanup project, which has been on for a year, and there are various projects across various cities where citizens are getting involved. There should be a method in which these projects can get in touch with the government, where the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan can actually help these people out, whether it's in resources, machines that can help them clean the beach, or in funds that could help them do a better job. Is there a possibility that we can create some sort of avenue like that?
Yes, new machines, new techniques is the need of hour in various places. At various places, this has been brought, and the utilization of money is headed towards that. As I said, that in the urban areas, the money will be spent on the machinery and the handling of the solid waste.
This is the key. This is how the Abhiyan is going to take forward the things.
All right, we've unfortunately run out of time on this particular discussion. But for our audience watching at home, I'm going to put up you know, contact details on your screen. And I want you to send us photographs or videos of anything you see in your city, around your home, on your street corner, especially around places like schools and hospitals. Send us photographs, send us videos, and we'll get in touch with your local government and make sure that India is in fact Swachh before we run into the Diwali festive season. Let's attempt to make our surroundings as clean as we like to keep our homes.
You can watch live TV on our website mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.